Hello there, everybody. DJ Numa here with me, myself, and I this week, as Dawn of Roxas is sadly out of town, so you're stuck with me. Anyways, welcome to the Dragon Ball Z League's My League Season 8, week number 11. We've got some great matches coming up for you tonight, starting with We Three Kings versus the Lefties. Let's do this. I'm hitting the wrong button. Let's do this. There we go. Got quite a few people in the chat today. Started a little bit later than normal, but you know what? I like it because there's a lot of you in chat, and it's going to be a great week. I apologize for my voice this week since I had a show last night and kind of blew my voice out slightly. Spectating afterwards. It was fun. Anyways, King Vegeta gets things started with his King America outfit. It's a charge battle against him and Tien. It should be rather interesting, really, who comes out on top here. Counter from King Vegeta. So far, Tien has done zero damage this week, which is kind of sad. Dodon Ray will not connect. And my roommates are yelling in the background, "What did you do, Hayden?" King Vegeta using Explosive Wave, and he wastes the fact that he just tried to charge up. Charging to max, both of them. Can we see a Neo Tri-Beam from Tien? That'd be rather interesting right now. King Vegeta, Tien finally did a little damage. Orga Blast from King Vegeta misses. We still see a Neo Tri-Beam from Tien. We saw it last week. And we're not going to see anything this week. We're not going to see anything done. Tien finally doing some damage. Going back up to max. Could he Neo Tri-Beam? Could he? Will he is a better question. Come on, Tien. Come on, Tien. Or King Vegeta will just keep stomping him and get a full bar lead even with 10 days. Solar Flare, very useful right now. If Tien wanted to, he could have fired off his ultimate. Wow, I just realized something. Tien, hey, he did damage. Tien and Chiaotzu's moves are very detrimental to their health. Especially Chiaotzu's. There we go. Tien's got a pretty large lead now, at least. Was around a half a bar. Now it's down to about maybe an eighth. King of Saiyans gets it off. Got a bonus to all of his stats now. Dodon Ray is not going to hit. If King Vidoo will charge, he can beat Tien to max. Key Blast Cannon. And King Vegeta is all the way over now. Woohoo! And what looked so at the beginning of this fight seems to have turned into quite a one-sided battle between King Vegeta and Tien. Never mind, it's actually still very back and forth. King Vegeta bringing it back to straight melee action, and Tien grabbing and punching. Another Solar Flare, not going to connect, he wasn't looking at you, Tien. Dodon Ray, dodge. He knew, Tien. He knew what you were going to try and do. He knew, man. Super Energy Wave Volley. We'll connect for 1,500 points of damage, it looks like. Tien back at him. I'll see that graphical error there where it looked like he had another bar of health when it almost went to the to this bar. Still even. Wow. Execution beam connects, and this is very quickly turning into a King Vegeta fight. As Tien, I don't think can keep up with the damage output, but if Tien can take out King Vegeta, in ape form at least, I think that the lefties definitely have the upper hand, simply because King Cold and King Piccolo. While King Piccolo is very, very consistent, King Cold does not show the consistency that he normally, that he has in previous weeks, recently. He's just not been as consistent. And Tien is still taking it to King Vegeta. He's going to lose this flash, though. And there goes Tien. And in comes Nail and Future Go. First Nail. And Nail's moves, I don't think he has a Rush B2. I'd be wrong. But dang, look at those grabs. King Vegeta's howling. Gets knocked out of it by straight up melee from Nail. And can the lefties bring back this in any shape or form? I mean, they're going to have a losing record no matter what. But if they can start a winning streak now, it'll be very, very, very beneficial going into next season. Because they might not be in South Kai. They might end up in West Kai next season. Which is really a shame because they've been in North Kai since the inception of this variant of the league. I believe the first season that they existed, or that the league existed, they were not in North Kai simply because we had it alphabetically. But they were brought in and went to the Budokai Bowl 2 seasons in a row now. We're in season 3 of the new incarnation. So, again, the lefties, very strong team, very, very strong team. And, just recently, they haven't been showing it this season. Now, that was partly due to coaching and lack thereof. But King Vegeta just took down Nail. So I'm going to say that this is definitely Week 3 King's match because he just tagged. Gohan has to sweep Week 3 Kings right now in order to win this. And he's got to do 2 full characters. Yes, and King Vegeta did just go elite. 2 super explosive waves just cancel each other out. I've not seen that happen, but I'm glad to see that it can happen. Best move in the game, canceled by itself. Seems legit. King Vegeta actually went elite before Nail died because of the Dende's healing on Tien. Don't know exactly what he did, but he definitely just went elite, because taking down 2 characters in and of itself is 100,000 damage. And if you can't tell, I'm also playing off what the chat says this week, just because it'll allow for a little bit of different commentary, I feel. Masenko from Gohan. He's doing well against King Cold, but he cannot afford to take any more damage from him. He has to annihilate King Cold and just sweep King Piccolo, and then he's got a bar left of King Vegeta. So it is possible, because neither of them have Dende's. And he's doing a great job so far. He needs to avoid going Super Saiyan, though, because when he goes Super Saiyan, he has the defense minus, the natural defense minus. King Cold tags, almost sealing Fate. Super Saiyan connects. Your Name Is Drum will not connect. Good job from Gohan. But when Gohan goes Super Saiyan, Super Saiyans get a natural defense minus. Yes, they get an inherent attack +2, I believe, and defense -1. But that will not help in this instance. What Gohan needs to do is go over to King Cold, do that, have that connect, and not take any damage from him. Especially one of these. And I don't think that it's going to be enough to get... Yeah, no. He's down to his last bar, and I'm calling it right here, folks. Week 3 Kings, well done this week. Now, Gohan can still do this, but I don't think he's going to be able to... Yeah, no. No. King Cold lands one more thing. If anyone lands one more punch, it's done. And... Yeah. King Cold, weakest member of Week 3 Kings this week. And not for nothing, he had to go up against Gohan. But there it is. King Piccolo, King Vegeta. Great work, guys. And we're on to the next match, which features, I believe, the Little Green Men versus the Baldies. Let's find out. No, it is 2.5 Saiyans versus the Baldies. That's right, because we could see an Ape Turles this week. That'll be great.
All right, I'm not losing to you.
What? You want to fight me?
Hmm. Interesting. Now, if there was a Gohan, oh, that was almost a beam struggle just at the very beginning of the match, and we're already off to a very, very, very stellar beginning to this match. Gohan's already down a bar of health, Hui almost down a full bar as well, and that's just from melee from Gohan. Gohan already has enough bars to do another Masenko. And again, I apologize for the fact that my voice is slightly less excitable today. I just can't get it to go any higher. this is my normal speaking volume. Actually, funny enough, usually I'm louder. Anyways, we got a Masenko from Gohan. Does not connect again. Pick a pick. Another Masenko. False Courage from Kui does not do anything for him. Full power energy barrage. Nothing. Guys, close in on each other. I know you don't want to, but just go. Kui, I know you've got the Living Light Grenade himself with the Living Light Grenade build, but I don't want to keep relying on Piccolo because he's literally been carrying your ass the entire season. Super Unyielding Spirit, Gohan goes max. Will we see an ultimate from Gohan? Kui goes max. Full power energy away from Kui. Dodge. Gohan uses his ultimate right now. Kui is done. Like, without a doubt, Kui is done. Kui, please do more than 20,000 damage this week. Thank you. And Gohan should win this. I think he's got a clash bonus. Yep. Rescue Madan, and there goes Kui. He did 23,000 damage. Good job, Kui. Dory Headbreaker. Missed. Oh, boy. Why is the Dory so bad? And it looks like Shiro, even though he hasn't changed build the entire season, is doing rather well. Again, 2.5 Saiyans, a super powerful team. Their record does not, reflect how good they are. Kid Gohan, actually, for example, is third place damage wise in rankings. So that'll tell you something. If the Baldies can take down Gohan, that's huge. But it's almost like going up against Metal Mania or even the Baldies. If you could take down Piccolo on the Baldies, you've won, basically. Because they've got Dodoria and Kui basically crippling them. Mostly Kui. And Gohan tags. In comes Turles. Now if Dodoria can take down Turles before he goes Ape, then that'll be a huge bonus. Which he should, because technically Dodoria is a more high-class warrior. Cheerios. Oof. Basically, Piccolo needs to go elite in order to bring this back at this point. This is not a good. Oh, Doria. I've made a mistake in keeping my lineup the same. I thought about changing it this week. I'm the coach of the Baldies, obviously. I thought about changing my lineup this week and making it so that I counter-built to Shiro because he hasn't changed his lineup all season. But then I was sitting there thinking, you know, I don't think that I need to simply because of how my team have been performing this week. Yeah, we've lost a match or two, but they've been performing far superior to what I thought they were. And then there's Turles, who decided this week, hey, I'm going to actually wake up and, you know, play. So, Dodoria Headbreaker, will it connect? It connects. Third time's the charm, bud. Charging up again. Full power energy barrage misses, thankfully. Fruit He's going to get it off. Dodoria's going to go max, though. So we could see a Dodoria, whatever the freak he does. Chamacow? Is that his ultimate? I don't remember. Yes. Chamacow. And Dodoria attacks, and in comes Piccolo. We could fire one of his Hellzone grenades. Piccolo. Piccolo. Oh, thankfully that missed. That would have been bad, man. And Piccolo starts charging. Could we see the light grenades from hell? But not the Hellzone grenades. There's the light grenade. That's one. Let's get a running count going in the in the chat. How many light grenades will Piccolo throw out this week? He's on TNAI. How many light grenades will he get to throw out this week? He will stop Turles from eating his fruit, though. False courage from Piccolo. Ooh, bad choice, Turles. Well. That's two special beam cannons. In comes Goku. Piccolo, why would you eat a Kamehameha? I guess he figured, you know what, I've special beam cannoned my way out of all these. I must be immune to them. Nope. Oh, good dodge, Piccolo. Alright. Piccolo got enough power to fire a light grenade. What? He's got quick charge. How did that not fire? Oh, God. Piccolo. Why? There you go. Good job, Piccolo. Another light grenade. Hey. Piccolo wins it. I'm very confused, but it happened. Oh, Hellzone grenade. Connects. And Piccolo's out. And in comes the Dodoria. What's going on? Other than a Chamacow to Dodoria's face. Or Goku's face. And it looks like the Baldies turned it around with the thing, with the help of Piccolo. Okay. And now the only one left is Kid Gohan. Here we go. Wow. Now, it could end up being mentor versus student here at the end. And it more than likely will be, given how Gohan does. But I think that a couple of light grenades, a couple of special beam cannons, and Gohan will learn his place. However, and wow, Dodoria, good job. Down goes Dodoria, and in comes Piccolo. Should be at roughly the same HP, so it's an even fight, folks. Actually, Chad, it was two light grenades. Come on, Piccolo. Piccolo. Piccolo!
Is this because of Mr. Piccolo's training?
Yes, Gohan. It was because of Mr. Piccolo's training that you just beat your mentor. Good job, 2.5 Saiyans. I'm gonna have to have a talk with my team. Anyway, we're on to the third match. We've got Team Shortcake versus the Evolution of Evil. Let's do this. Yeah, it was two light grenades. One of them clashed with a Kamehameha. Anyway, we're on Dynamic now, and the Evolution of Evil is versing a pumpkin. They've got the exact same voice actor. Perfect. Perfect. Junior has had a rough season, let's be honest here, folks. He's finally starting to sweep the leg again, but right up until this point, he's just been kind of lackluster, as the entire team has been, really. Evil Boo the exception, but again, two of the more powerful teams from Season 1 or Season 6, and they're not doing anything, really. So, yeah, interesting. And Garlic Jr. sweeps the leg again. More like the pumpkin bug, but there you go. And he's at max. Can we see Dead Zone? Is Dead Zone this one? No, this one's the two balls. I always forgot about that. And still, a relatively even fight this week. A lot of even fights. More so than the majors. And it's also worth noting that after this week, last season, and the season before, we would have been in the playoffs. So, yeah. Yeah, that's all I gotta say is yeah. Another sweep the leg, and it takes down Pilaf. Oh god, in comes the other short one. In theory, Garlic Jr. was slated to go under Shortcake, but we couldn't find anybody to really replace him, because the only one that really could've is Pilaf, since it went Pilaf, you know, basically, Pilaf, Ginyu, Boo, you know, in terms of, like, sagas. Because Cell was slotted into Red Ribbon. And since this was, I believe, Garlic Jr. was originally in a Dragon Ball movie, not a DBZ movie, if I remember correctly. It might have been Dragon Ball. Not sure. But he showed up very early on. I mean, very early on. And if he was that, it would have been, like, technically between Dragon Ball and Dragon Ball Z, I guess. I can't remember. Garlic and Z, thank you very much. But yeah, it's... He was another one to slot into Shortcake, so... Really, it was either take Raditz off Mullet Club, or put Nappa on Evo, which would have gimped them beyond recognition. Anyway, in comes Super Evil Boo, jumping his spot in line, because this week they were actually in canonical order. Well, not canonical order, because Garlic is filler, but they were in order of relative appearance, if you count the movies. Anyway, one thing I really like about these two characters is that no matter how bad they do, they always give us an exciting fight. I mean, Super Evil Boo typically fires off the Super Kamehamehas. And, you know, is overall a very super character. Chiaotzu throws rocks, and we always want him to explode, so we're always anticipating it. So, yeah. Although, they're both firing. Super Evil Blue's not firing very many anything this week. Given, you know, just in general, what's going on. And this is match number 3, and it's tied. Although, if Super Evil Blue does anything, it'd be great. And it doesn't look like Boo's going to get to do much of anything, really. And I'd say that definitely who's in the lead right now is freaking Boo's not done anything. There we go. Any tags? All right, so we're back to even. And we've got Purple Loser back from the dead. Hey, this is technically a cannon fight, right? Piccolo? Or, not Piccolo. Krillin fought against Ginyu? No? Okay. I just like starting arguments in chat by yelling cannon fight during things that happened simultaneous instances, but were not cannon at all. Anyway, Ginyu and Super Evil Blue could bring this back in theory. Could pull a freaking Gohan. Could pull a Metacore from last week. Hey, Krillin was there, okay? Dimension is like, I would say Krillin watched the fights with Ginyu, but that's the extent. And the chat's agreeing with him. I'm like, okay, yeah, but he was there. Would be great. Would be to get, see Ginyu go down to like his last bar of health and body change, because we haven't seen one of those this season. And interestingly, we've seen an attempt at one, I believe, but it failed miserably and got punched out of it. I think that was against Teen Gohan or Kid Gohan. Special fighting pose 5. Gets off and he's at max. We could see a body change, folks. Although we're probably gonna see that. Anyways, there's an expanding energy wave stopping Ginyu from hurting himself. Krillin, friend to all people, doing 900 damage with his freaking attack, and he was not facing you, Krillin. Either way, we're back to a oh well. Krillin's at max. We could see another Destructo Disc. Could, being the key word. Another special fighting pose 5. Could see a body change too. One thing I don't like about Ginyu in this is that he can't throw off any other player's moves. Body change! Connects! And we've got Piccolo. Where's that Nail? I think that's Nail. We've got Nail. And now it's definitely an uphill battle for Chaozu. Very uphill. I'm going to call it right here, folks. I don't think that he could go against Nail. I'm surprised that even though we're on Dynamic, he didn't get Frieza or somebody that's like more akin to being on Dynamic. Because Nail on Dynamic was not. Come on, Ginyu. Wow. I mean, yeah, even though he has detriments to all of his stuff, Chaozu just lost miserably, not even doing another bar of damage. What he could do is blow himself up. I don't think it's gonna happen. Oh, he just got KO'd by his own thing. I'm sorry, I couldn't do it. Oh, poor Chaozu. and Ginyu body changing changed the match around. So, we're on to match number 4. Last match of this episode, we have got the Mullet Club versus Red Ribbon with Bob Ross the Snowman sitting in the background. Sounds like my roommates are playing Battlefield.
Okay, come on.
We come here to die.
Yes, Cell. He has come here to die. Special beam cannon from Cell. And honestly, this is one of the better matchups for Cell, because Yamcha likes to be in your face. Cell likes to be. Doesn't really like to be in your face. He likes to charge. But at the same time, all of Cell's moves basically require your opponent to be in your face when you fire them. Kamehameha's, for instance. His grabs. And, you know, it just. Yeah.
Okay, Bob Ross the Snowman has requested a name change to Barry Bars the Snow Lantern Rapid.
And Cell doing a crap ton of damage. The Kamehameha hit for a couple of hundred before Yamcha fell backwards. After image from Cell. And this is, again, this is the kind of fight Cell needs. Is one that's in your face and one that he can basically control by using his tail. You know? Yeah, he doesn't get to fuse or anything like that, but he can basically control the fight as much as he wants, because he can be in your face against Yamcha. He also does. Yeah. Free Kamehameha connects. Wolfang Fist connects. And chat's just dissing Yamcha now. They're like, that's the only tail Yamcha's ever gonna get. And Cell not doing quite as well now. Granted, he took a Max Power Wolf Fang Fist, and that's going to end it right there with Cell, who did just under 20,000 damage. He pulled a Kui. So promising. But yeah, as Tao just said, it is time for work. Should be interesting. They're having a lot of fun over there. Crane style Assassin Strike. Oh, you go, Tao. Tao coming in, just dealing damage. And apparently there was either melee combos or something that I missed there, but Tao already took a bar of health. 2 bars of health. And Yamcha, 60,000 damage. Actually, more so because of the fact that Cell drained damage, drained life from it. So if Yamcha could take out Tao as well, he could go elite. Actually, probably if Yamcha could take out another bar Tao, he could go elite. Thinking about it, and make 2 bars. But no, he tags into Broly.
So strong.
And he gets grabbed out of Bloody Smash. Never mind, Broly. You're not strong anymore. He will be punched, though. Quite a bit. Full Power Energy Wave. And it's green, meaning it's 10 times better. Because Broly.
And Barry Bars is over there. Just sitting like, yo. Broly charging up. Broly could go Super Saiyan. Boom. Really, I need to question something. Broly goes into blue hair form. Does that... We've discussed this before, chat. But does that mean that Broly is a Super Saiyan... God Super Saiyan? That's how that works, right? If Broly's hair goes blue. And then he goes legendary. Is that how this works? Bloody Smash connects finally, and down goes Tao. Or not. I'm gonna just say this right here, right now. Broly is part Bojack. Just part. I mean, he's got the green energy, and he can fire trap shooters. And in comes General Blue. The last hope for Red Ribbon, Rocket Engine Spark, will miss miserably and make me a very, very sad Numa. If you guys can hear any of what's going on in the background, I apologize. Full Power Energy Wave misses. Punch, punch, kick, punch, punch, kick, punch. Alright, there we go. And he's coming. Broly is working his way through General Tao, or General Blue, sorry. Going to max. Will we see another Rocket Engine Spark that actually hits? Nope. We will see a Bloody Smash get blocked, though. Free shoot you. Doing about as much damage as one of Frieza's soldiers' moves. He'll skewer you, though. Alright. Good job, General Blue. Now he's got to take out the Wolf Fang of the Fist. And the Raditz. Wolf Fang Fist connects, eliminating basically any chance he has of beating the Mullet Club. And sadly, it looks like Red Ribbon's gonna lose another one. Makes me sad. An extra large spirit ball just for good measure. Yamcha, that's a dick move. 21,000 points of damage. I mean, if you're gonna go out. Yes, they got a really good taste of your Wolf Fang Fist, Yamcha. Anyways, folks, that's it for this episode. Bad luck, Red Ribbon. And I'll see you guys episode 2. Toodaloo.